You know where you are?
This is Nollywood Pictures TV.
Adanna!
Yeah.
Where are you coming from?
I've been to ease myself.
You mean you went outside this compound to ease yourself? Adanna, when did that start?
Nam, I have been doing that. Remember, you always taught me to learn how to grow above my fears. That is exactly what I am doing. I go out in the dark to ease myself. Something most maidens in the same age group with me will never even venture into. Nam, you really should be giving me a tap on the back for living up to the bravery your lineage. Catch you for.
Why do I have this strange feeling that she wants me to do my worst?
Bunch of leaves I threw away. Why did you return it back to me?
I remember that you shouldn't leave this bunch out there because you have sworn on it. So I went back there, picked it up, and I've returned it to you.
Ugoma, I don't know why you're bothering yourself over nothing. The prince is now history to me.
Don't swear on that. You can have a change of heart. You never can tell. Just keep it in a safe place. And if finally you decide to get rid of it, you can do it properly.
Kachifu.
Oh?
Nem.
Kodiechi.
Asked me to go and fetch the leaves. You went to sleep without even waiting for me to come back. That is not fair.
But I asked you already and you confirmed to me you didn't see the leaves. I don't have any reason to see you again.
Ichi Akabike, please, I need your help. There is something the ancestors are trying to teach me this night. Please, I need you to help me confirm what it is.
Go back to the palace and explore the people that have the information you seek. What do you want me to do for you when you don't even know the maiden that came to the palace with the basilisk leaves in the first place? What can I do for you?
Ichi Akabike, please, I need you to confirm if the ancestors have a hand in this.
Do you know what, Ifadigo? Go back and unmask the identity of the very maiden that came to the palace with the basilisk leaves. When you have done this, come back to me and I'm going to guide you into what the ancestors are trying to teach you this night. You don't have all the whole time. You have to go back to the palace. Kachifu.
Will it cost you anything to tell him the maiden that visited him?
Why do you like to dabble into things that don't concern you, this woman? Do you want me to kill you or come wogi?
My husband, I am your wife. And I am part of you. Whatever that concerns you is very important to me.
Don't always rely on the strength of Amaretto's status. To believe you can always make me do things. You cannot. I am a man of my words. I am a masquerade of Abaguna. I move when I decide to move. You cannot move me because you cannot. Don't provoke me, please. Because you don't know what is going on.
My husband.
Sleep. I don't want to discuss this any further.
Is my mother not awake yet?
She has been awake since early this morning.
Call her for me. I want to have a word with her.
She just had her bath. She's dressing up.
And where's Chinasa?
Chinasa? Were you not part of what happened last night?
What do you mean? I don't understand. What happened and where? I humbled myself before my mother, Iru Ezigbo of Omaguna Kingdom.
I am so disappointed in you, the coming king of Omaguna. Many young people look up to you for guidance. How could you start crawling the night?
I don't understand what you mean by crawling the night. So many things went wrong yesterday. I was only trying to see if I could remedy the ones that could be remedied.
So many things went wrong. Leave us. Son, what do you mean by so many things went wrong? And what are those things that went wrong?
Mother, I don't want to go into all that now. She was telling me about what happened last night before you interrupted. What could that be?
This is the first time the priest of Obada is visiting me at home. They say the toll does not run in afternoon for nothing. May I know the reason for this visit?
It is said that the visit of the masquerade is never without a message from the gods. There are things we think that we can control, but those things actually are the ones controlling us. I pleaded with you to temper justice with mercy, but you refused and insisted, so I compelled them. Now I see great mistake that would have been avoided.
Yes, Alice, I respect you as the priest. Have you come here this morning to preach to me on the same issue we resolved 30 years ago?
That's because the wind of the past is blowing and I see you helpless before the throat. You may cry so bad that no one will be there to listen.
Esavus, are you here to scare me?
Do you want to be helpless before the throat? I am the priest of the oracle, the sacred Obada, the deity of our forefathers. I do not scare my people. I only state the obvious and say what I see.
As Alice, I know you and respect you as the priest of our sacred Obada. I know you will not deceive me. Tell me, what do you want from me?
7 cows is what you must arrange urgently so that this danger that I see can be reversed.
Do you know what you're saying? How am I going to get 7 cows?
Ichi, you brought this upon yourself. For I pleaded with you to go back with your colonels. But you refused and insist that I must proceed with the prayers, which I did. Families that ought to be permanently separated are knitted in spirit. And this is so close for comfort. 7 cows must be provided, else danger shall descend in such a way that you will cry, and that which you seek for will never.
Yes, sir. 7 cows. How am I going to get 7 cows?
Father, I saw the priest of Obada leaving. What has he come to do?
Your closeness with that maiden has caused a problem that I must settle with 7 cows.
7 cows. What kind of problem is that?
I swore on my father's grave before, and I forgave you because you are my own son. Today, I swear on the sons of our people, and there is no going backwards. If you don't defend yourself from that maiden, I will kill you.
Father, you have not seen me the whole of today. I am just coming back from hunting and you're threatening to kill me? Why?
Do you think that your fully stupid life still makes a meaning to me? Refuse to separate from that maiden, and I will teach you the way the men and women of Amagona will marvel.
Why are you compounding my problem? Why did you send her packing just like that?
If that's the way you say it, that means you don't have respect for your mother.
How?
A maiden that worked for me in this palace was insulting me before your face, telling me that I did not know the tradition of this land, and you want me to leave her here.
Mother, you misunderstood this maiden completely.
And I don't want to go into that. The fact remains that she is fired, and that is final.
Did you consult my father before sending her packing?
Who is she? Ifarigo, I'm asking you, who is she that I should obtain permission from my husband before firing her? I forbid you never to disturb my sick husband with the tales of Chinasa. She proved to me that she is not worthy of this royal household, and I sent her back in for good, and that is final.
I ran into Onini of Evida village,
bearing a bunch of umbatilico leaves in hand last night. Was she the one you dismissed from the palace?
I humbled myself before the Queen Mother. You shall live long.
I humbled myself before the Queen Mother of Amagona. You are our source of inspiration, and you shall live long.
I am curious for the picture here. Who are you, and why are you here with a bunch of umbachiliku leaves?
My name is Onyinye, a maiden from this land, from Egede village, Your Majesty. I was part of the maidens that gathered for Egwu Oganigwe.
You have not answered my question, and I repeat, why are you here with a bunch of this?
Your Majesty, the revelation came to me that the prince is passing through a dilemma. I was moved to make the move, for I know that I can solve the dilemma for the prince. Your Majesty.
I see.
Don't keep me quiet! I'm in a state of dilemma.
And something tells me that that girl's mission was made possible by the gods of this land. Mother, tell me, was she the one you dismissed from the palace?
My son, you were born the freeman of this land. And you are going to reign after your father. You are not in a dilemma. Stop cursing yourself.
Mother, you are deviating from my question. And I don't like it. Was she the one you dismissed from the palace yesterday?
I want to attend to my sick husband. Excuse me, please.
Mother! She is the cause of my problem. Why did I even listen to her?
Adam, you asked me to give you till this morning to make a decision. I want to know, what have you decided?
Okay, I just want to be sure that come rain, come shine, he will be mine.
I promise you again and again that I am yours forever. Nothing, absolutely nothing on earth is going to change that.
Adam Oyelinaya Omalecha. I'm waiting for an answer. You see, the prince wants to take you as wife, and I want to give you to him as wife because he's the one who is qualified to have someone like you as wife. What am I going to tell the prince?
Nam, this whole thing is very tough for me, but I have decided to end it once and for all. I will never marry the prince. My heart and life belong to Atuanya, and I will never for anybody in this life leave him.
Adiku does not deserve the attention he gets. I mean, this is a man that doesn't even know what he wants. He's so confused. Omari Hocho, Osinon Keta, Osinon Kaichi, Oginidi. There's no woman on earth that would want that kind of man for a husband. God forbid.
As I got close to him, I discovered he's not what we thought he is. He triggered so much love from afar. By the time I got close to him, he triggered hatred. I regret ever going there.
We may not have to blame the prince, but what happened to the prince can happen to anybody. Yes. He wanted a maiden who had already given herself to another man. He found himself in a dilemma, and we should be praying for him to come out of what is coming his way instead of sound this way.
He has the solution to his problem. As he has refused to solve his problem himself, are we going to kill ourselves?
My prince.
My prince. My prince. This is the first time you're coming to my place. So what do I owe the honor of the visit?
I am glad both of you are here. I am the prince of this land. And I know I have never offended either of you. I want to believe you regard my problem as your problems.
Oh,
What is the meaning of what you just did? You blinded your own daughter simply because you find the man she loves?
Listen to me, Ekwazo. Don't preach to me. If she goes blind, then serves her right. I want her to stay away from that descendant of my enemy. I even asked her to marry the prince who is interested in her, but she wouldn't listen to me.
That is never enough reason for you to do what you did. She's a woman, you know. How could you even hit a woman with a walking stick?
Ekwazo, the question should be, why should a woman not obey her father? Why?
On an issue that borders on her life and future? You ought to have allowed her to go for the one that promises her peace and love.
Say that to the vultures, Ekwazo. I have already made up my mind I will kill her and know that I have no child.
That is a reckless thing for you to say. God forbid.
Oh, you can say anything. Ekwazo, I want to be left alone.
I will not leave you alone. You have done an abominable thing. If that girl goes blind permanently, where will you find a man that will marry her? Even the priest will not marry her. Eh? What have you done?
Oh, my friend.
Adanna is the one you love. This is something we already established and we are leaving you to follow the one you love. My prince, please, why are you here?
I came here for a gentle inquiry. You already called me your prince, and I want to believe you will not lead me astray. Why did you embark on that journey yesterday, bearing Umbachiliku leave in hand?
That visit is already overtaken by events, for I regretted even coming there in the first place.
That is a hard thing to say. Why are you regretting the innocent visit you made to me?
My prince, I'm sorry. Bikiwewe Kwanagi, sorry to interrupt you. My advice to you is that you go after one woman, the one you truly love. Not every other maiden in the land. It makes you lose relevance, dignity and respect in the eyes of all.
Chinasa.
My prince.
I need a favor from you. Please don't say no.
What is the favor, my prince?
I want you to follow me to the palace to see my mother. We have so many things to do together.
Follow you to the palace? Your mother issued a threat to kill me if she ever sees me anywhere close to the palace. I have a life ahead of me. I don't want to die, my prince.
You know that's not true. I am the prince in that palace. My mother will never harm you when I'm there.
She has done more than harm to me. Still, nothing happened. I'm sorry, my prince. I'm not going back to that palace.
You have not answered my question, my dear. Why are you regretting the innocent visit you made to me last night?
My prince, I believe I'll find an answer later. For now, I sincerely don't have any answer.
He said the priest of Obada demanded for 7 cows to solve the problem. What is this problem? You are the seer that we know, and I believe you would have a ready answer to give.
You believe I have an answer to give you? What if I don't?
That would be difficult to believe. Akabike is a man among men. He's a mighty man of valor whom even the spirits adore. He should have an answer to give to a man like me who has come under your ministration.
Atuanya, I would have loved you to dwell on what concerns you directly.
What concerns me directly
Like what and what?
The maiden you love. She has been tampered with and I see your love evaporating. This is the time for the man to prove he knows something about love.
You confuse me with your words. How do you mean she has been tampered with?
Leave your father to look for the seven cows, because he brought the confusion upon himself. Concern yourself with what concerns you. Adanna is the one you love, and she is the one that has been tampered with. This is time for you to prove you love her. Do it, and do it now.
How will they survive what is coming? Obodo na sini bu honye mku Manu uche gini
Uhunde onye mmanya
Uche gino yao
Omunku
Nekwendo onye
Ichie mo loku A heartless fighter that kills what he can never eat. I bow down in greetings.
Mude, what do you mean by what you have just said?
Men can always use their powers to separate two stones that are rolling together. The strength is this. They will always find a way of meeting again and continue to roll. When they meet this time, it will be very difficult for anybody to separate them.
Come back here. Let me warn you. Let this be the last time you will block my way and speak to me in riddles. The next time you try it, you will not like what I will do.
Had it been you accorded me the respect I deserve as the man of truth of Amagono, I would have told you something that will register joy in that your heart.
Keep it to yourself. Keep it to yourself. You are nothing but a frustrated drunk. And there is nothing that you can tell someone like me that can trigger joy in my heart. Don't force me to warn you the hard way.
Out of the eater came something to eat. You are the original eater. Now the original eater is doing everything possible to prevent the eater from eating what he can eat. I want to ask you, Ichiemo Loku, how long are you going to continue to sustain this war? How long can you be Alotogwa?
Come back. Come back here. Something tells me that you have been making inquiries on my family. Now tell me, what and what do you know?
You now want you here. Am I no longer the same drunkard that can never say anything to register joy in your heart? I still remember what you said. You said it now, here and now. You know what? Don't bother, go. It's not necessary.
Come back here.
Go.
Come back here.
Keep it to yourself.
I'm talking to you. Come and explain what you mean. He's a drunk. But he seems to know something much more than a drunk.
Okay. Nen, I still cannot see anything. No. This sudden blindness has something to do with charms. My father has blinded me. My father has blinded me. Nen, I cannot see anything. I cannot say anything.
Please, Adanna, stop reading unnecessary meaning into this. You start seeing again soon. You are the elite of the ancestors and favored of the gods. Even if they need chance, the chance can never have effect in you.
Nen, I can feel his presence. I can smell him, the Lord of my life. The only one I will love forever. Atuanya is here. Obim, where are you?
Adanna, what is it? Why are you behaving like someone who can't see?
I cannot see again.
What are you talking about? Eh?
I cannot see again. My father struck me with his walking stick and I cannot see anything.
What are you talking about, Adanna? You can see. You can see. Look at me. Open your eyes. Look at me, Adanna.
My eyes are open, but I cannot see anything. I'm blind. Obim, I have gone blind.
Adanna, you can't see me. Look at me now. Look at my eyes.
Atuanya, please. Don't make her look hopeless. Her condition is temporary. My daughter is going to see again.
Hey. Are you serious? Where's Ichemoloku?
He lives without a word.
Does he know what he has done?
She's going to see you again.
I'm going to open your eyes. Can you see me now? Adanna, you can see me. Stop saying this now. Look at me now.
I cannot see anything.
Hey!
I cannot see anything.
Adanna, you cannot see me.
Make it clear to me. Adanna, daughter of Ishiemoloku Kanna Juno, the mourner na bany. Will she ever see again? Hi. Isimbiat kwana na bambi. Siakub kone wunda makanota law kulunda. Will she ever see again?
Oh, she provoked me beyond the limit I could take, so I lost it. Ichiakabike. Please, I don't want anything to happen to my daughter.
Please. He doesn't want anything to happen to his daughter. And I'm asking you, reveal it to me, make it clear to me. Will she ever see again? There is a man of Ifite named CDN. Do you know this man?
Yes, I know him. He was the one who carved this walking stick for me.
Do you still remember what he told you the day he gave you this walking stick?
Does Isidienu have anything to do with this?
Ichemoloku, I asked a very simple question. Question that came as I was making metaphysical inquiries. That question has not been answered, and I wonder why. What did Isidienu tell you the day he gave you this walking stick?
I brought you to this junction. We had 3 foot patch made to deliver this to you. You will take it to another junction. We have 3 foot past meet to unveil it. This is Unpo Ekuleku, the secret of Ekuleku warriors. It has blinding powers that come out when we are frustrated and terribly provoked. Use it when you stand face to face with death. Mainly death from enemies that must kill you if you fail to act. Unkpo Ekuleku is deep and powerful and can blind even the most powerful of men.
From the way you sound, Isidino, you have given me a sham instead of a walking stick. But that was not what I paid for.
Isidino of Ifite has his own set of rules. Yes, you begged me to carve a simple walking stick for you. But I discovered you need powers. Freely, I've given to you the powers of the dreaded Ekulek warriors. This walking stick has the power to blind your attackers and you slaughter them like chicken. I tell you something immediately. If you use it well, you can become the most dreaded person in your Amaguna.
But honestly, you still haven't told me why you gave me charms instead of a walking stick that I paid for.
Well, I can take it back and give you a basic walking stick that has nothing. But I am convinced that a man who is a man needs something to protect himself, something to intimidate his attackers. And that is what I've given you. Mpo Ekuleku.
Does it have any adverse effects?
Every charm made by men for other men have adverse effects. That is why they are called charms. The adverse effects start to come when we start to abuse the charms. Use it only on your enemies. Enemies that will want you dead. Enemies that intimidate you. But I must warn you, do not use it on your friends and your family members. That is when the adverse effect will come.
Why are you looking at me as if you didn't hear what I asked you? He gave you the walking stick. Can you still remember what he told you the day he gave you the walking stick?
I did not take those words he told me that day. I didn't give them a second thought. I didn't. And I never planned for what he started. I merely paid him to carve me a walking stick because he was a man good with woods.
You know, one good thing about men of Ifite is that they can never lie. You paid him to carve you a walking stick. And he did. Then in his benevolence, he sparked the walking stick with powers of a Kuleku to make you a great man of your land. And he told you exactly what he did.
Yes, he told me what he did. I'm not denying that.
Ever since he gave you the walking stick, you never used it. The very first time you decided to use the walking stick, the person you remembered, your own daughter, your only child. Yeah, Ishemoloku, should I tell you the truth? I am very, very disappointed in you. Ogunede,
Chakabike, you cannot continue to blame me because it was a mistake. And that's why I'm here. I'm here to remedy the situation. I am ready to pay.
There is nothing I can do to remedy what you did. You may find help from Isidienu himself. There is nothing. There is nothing I can do on my own. Mumana.
You want to know the truth? I do not see any other. He is all that I see because he is not a pretender like all of you. What he sees, he says it, and he says it as he sees it.
What did Moody do to her? That made her speak to me like that. What?
Ibezin. My mother said you were at my place and that you asked that I see you as soon as I return. What is it all about?
It's good that you are here. Of all the maidens of this land, you are among the few I hold in high esteem. And I know you will not betray me.
Something is going on in your mind. What is it?
Of all the young men in this land, you chose to love Mude. Why?
You actually called me here to discuss who I love and who I don't love.
Not really. I'm making an innocent inquiry that will benefit you and benefit me. Why stick with Moody of all the men in this kingdom? I'm asking you why.
You know, it is clear to me that you're so jobless in this land that you've made Moody your job. And then I ask you, has he ever offended you? What has he done to you?
I was once with Moody before a seer. And the seer said something strong. And it's clear to me that it's all about you.
A seer? Who is this seer? And what did he or she say about me?
You see, being a ton of bumpy, when I want to muddy, all muddy kind of going to be see when I would okay. The queen would, the queen be seen, now above all, Grania, near road. Could even my one and dear mood and the be seen are here before me, and above all, give my one dear. Both of you are progressive young men of this kingdom, and you are going to be prosperous in life. But what I am seeing here is not acceptable to me, because suddenly I see a woman coming between both of you to create a problem. Who is this woman that will make both of you fall out with one another? Who is she?
I know myself very well. I can never allow a woman to make me fall out with my fellow man. Ibezim, I don't know about you. Are you going to allow a woman to make you fall out with me?
No, you know for yourself that that cannot happen. Eh? We are here to make a prosperity sacrifice to the great Akoneko, the god of our ancestors. We shouldn't be talking about women. We shouldn't.
My friend has just said something important. When you look at it, I agree with him completely. We are here to look into the future and know how prosperous we can be. And we shouldn't be discussing women.
I never told you we are discussing women. I am telling you what I am seeing. A day is coming in the future when confusion shall envelop men in your age bracket. Some of you shall go berserk and go back to their vomit, while others shall publicly deny what they said they love. A woman is going to appear suddenly and create confusion between both of you. The way you handle that woman will determine how Akuneko shall bless both of you.
But Ichie, don't be annoyed with me. Why must our all-powerful Akuneko involve a woman in something that has to do with our future and prosperity? Why?
It came up simply to guide you. Women are sweet. I can confirm to you that they are the sweetest of all the sweet things known to men. But women are evil. Don't allow a woman to create problem for you. Don't allow a woman to separate both of you. Don't allow a woman to create confusion between both of you.
You will not waste my time here like this. Who is this seer and what did he or she say about me?
Calm down. Calm down. And please. If you are made to make a choice between that drunk idiot Mude and myself,
Who would you choose?
You must be out of your mind to have called me here for this kind of a useless discussion. This is why you called me.
It took me time to understand who you really are. And now I know. You're beautiful. Special. And I want to make you my wife.
You should be thinking about what? Oh, and I am going to descend on you with my bare hands if I hear one more word from you.
Ude, you will not get away with this. Ude,
listen to me. I don't want to hear any explanation here. Now, follow me. Are you ready to follow me? I'll come back to you.
I will meet you.
A woman is going to appear suddenly and create confusion between both of you. The way you handle that woman will determine how Apuneka shall bless both of you.
Let's be the confusion. Who is who there to beat me? In winning a woman?
Ebuwe, let me be. Let me be, Ebuwe. For I have been by myself here at this very spot where my Atuanya asked me to wait for him. I did not call for your help. I don't need it and I will never need your help. Ebuwe, Apumaka.
Adanna! As you have elected to talk to me that way, I shall teach you the lessons of your life.
You again?
The lessons of your life today! How dare you lay your cursed finger on my woman? Are you mad?
Adanaya Adadema Adadema na magolo Iligo Atuanya bi ogebu madu maka iki Atuanya deche maka iu wagebu Idiyama odigima Iya soro wahamebe Adadema na magolo Iligo Atuanya bi Ewo iligo Atuanya bi
Adadema na magolo
iligo Atuanya bi.